Hello Vogue, it's Naomi Campbell here. I'm going to walk you through my looks of all the Met Balls that I attended over the years. This is quite a thrill. So here we go. So the first look is 1990. It's Gianni Versace. It was the first Met Ball I ever attended. I was in such awe to first be invited by Gianni Versace through my roommate, Christy Turlington. The 90s was, you wore everything. You dressed up in the 90s. If you didn't matter if you're going for dinner, we would all go to dinner outside of work. Christy, Linda, I, we would dress up. You know, enjoy your clothes, enjoy your accessories, enjoy your hair. This one also, I'm wearing Gianni Versace. Wow, I loved this dress. It was slim fitting and body hugging and just glistened. I remember when I saw this dress for the first time, I thought, wow, Gianni, is that for me? It seemed like one of those dresses that you read in those fairy tale books, you know? So here we are, 2001. The theme was Jackie Kennedy. I can't quite say that we actually were appropriate for the theme, but at any rate, we were wearing Dolce & Gabbana. Getting to be next to Iman, who I love and respected and always looked up to, was just, you know, another dream conquered in my life. For the Met Ball, it's primping the whole day. It's kind of crazy. You know, you get like a facial, or you do your nails, or you get some kind of wellness treatment to feel good about yourself. And then you start with the hair and makeup around 3. If you're doing 4, you're pushing it. 2003, and here I am wearing Dolce again with Victoria Beckham. I love this whole collection they did with like the sewing and the lace. I still have this dress. It was definitely ruby red night because I've got tons of rubies on it. I've got a choker and a crucifix. Mistake. Definitely less would have been best on the neck. So here I am, 2006, and this was the Anglomania. So as a Brit, you know, I wanted to wear a Brit. Anna had thought that it would be a great idea if I wore Alexander McQueen. This was to be his last season at Givenchy. So Anna actually chose the color of my pale green dress. And then Lee did his magic with the Givenchy staff. And one of the things I remember so much from the fitting is how much Lee loved his staff and how he treated them. It's just one of my fittings I'll never forget. I felt very neat and I felt very simple and classic, but in a good way. I didn't feel like I'd overdone it. I felt like it was all a good package. So this is 2007. I'm in no other than my papa, Azzedine Alaia, which I think women all over the world aspired and loved Azzedine Alaia for the way he made our bodies look. What can I say? It was always a unique experience to be fitted by papa, for him to create on your body in the middle of the night and to see the finished product. And he did everything himself. I have the fondest memories of all of those times. Few years have gone by and I hadn't been to the Met, so now we skip to 2010 and I'm back to my old pals again. When you feel that you want to be that Sicilian type of voluptuous woman, you go to no other than Dolce & Gabbana. I actually think my hair was not working. Not at all. Should have just been straight, no curls. And I could have done without the lips too. Lady Gaga performed at this one. It now became like 10 times bigger. Everybody and anybody was at the Met. It's a great turnout for fashion and our industry. It's our Oscars. Okay, so we go to 2011, which was a very bittersweet Met. A lot of tears and sadness still, as it was for our beloved Alexander McQueen. And Sarah Burton, who I got to know while working with Lee over the years, made me a beautiful dress. It's a masterpiece to me. This dress was so intricate because it was made on a corset that was sheer, made to my skin color. It had like a long train cape, but it was not really a cape, it was connected to the dress at the back. I felt like I was really embodying Lee the best I could in his honor. I do think my hair could have been more simple if Lee had been alive, because he was someone that would always tell us what he liked, he would have said straight and that's it. Straight and back, I think. So here we are, now speeding forward to 2014. My God, I've been to so many men. Charles James Beyond Fashion was the exhibition, and I was wearing Givenchy by Riccardo Tisci. He was so clear in his vision what he wanted me to wear, and he just said, I want you to be kind of Diana Ross-ish and glamorous. And I loved that it was like a pale, soft baby pink. I felt very warm and girly and flirty. I felt very comfortable in my skin in this dress. With Riccardo, with this dress from Givenchy, I think I did like one fitting and then the day off. As models from the beginning, we never really got involved with what the designers wanted to put us in. We'd just say, okay. I mean, it would have to be something like really, really ridiculous for us to say we won't wear that. It just never happened. It just was easy. Here we are, 2015, a year later, and the theme for this year was China through the looking glass. I wanted to wear Burberry, and Christopher Bailey was the artistic director of Burberry, and so Burberry's what we wore. When I first met Christopher Bailey, he worked at Gucci when Tom Ford was the creative director. So I know that Christopher Bailey knew how to make me a sexy dress, and he did. Yeah, I loved this dress. It was like a chartreuse sequins, matte, with feathers at the bottom, like an ostrich feather, and it was just really, really close to my body. I had a long plunging neckline, no jewelry this time, absolutely nothing. Not one necklace, zilch. I just wore a bracelet and that was it. It was great, I loved this dress, and I got to have accompany me my wonderful and great friend, director Lee Daniels. It was a fun met, and it was a fun after party too that night. We were out dancing all night long. 2016, Manus Machina. And so it's more this futuristic thing. There were some intricate dresses. There were dresses with electricity. I mean, I cannot tell you. I was wearing Peter Dundas and I thought, I just want a simple dress. It was a kind of bra top, then a skirt. Then he connected the bra top to the skirt. And he did that on the Sunday, the day before the Met. We thought about putting a big feather coat, but then we just thought it was too much. It was just better to go simple like that. Okay, so here we are, 2017. It's Comme des Garçons. And I've known Ray Karakouba and worked for Ray since I was 16, since 1986. So it was such an honor. I mean, she could do like five exhibitions without repeating the same thing easy, because she's just got so much amazing archive. This was the first time I'd gone to the Met without a designer. So I was like, okay, what am I gonna wear? Of course, you know what I wore. I wore Izina Laya, I wore my papa. And it was this black velvet dress with these pleats and like pressed metal that just went all the way around and a very high split. It wasn't that high, but we made it higher than it was. I also wanted to wear a lyre to this one because Azzedine and Ray Karakouba were very, very close friends. And so I thought it would be appropriate. So here we are, skipping 2 years forward to 2019. And this Met Ball is called Camp, C-A-M-P. We used to say that word in the late 80s and 90s the whole time. Oh, she's so camp, he's so camp. As you can imagine, the word camp, you can go in so many directions, up, down, across, whatever. And that's exactly how it went down. I was going to the Met this year with Sir Johnny Ive. So I chose this year to wear Pier Paolo Valentino, Maison Valentino, Pier Paolo. So here comes Saturday. I go up to Valentino's store to do my fitting. I try my dress, but there was something, I don't know, it was too much fabric, I felt. And Pier Paolo came and he completely started the dress from scratch. Basically, he made me a bodysuit and put like a skirt around. And then I had that incredible cape. I mean, my outfit was really lace tights and a chiffon top with a chiffon skirt around. And it was made in like 30 hours. I think that's the most fun I've had at the Met ever. It was incredible to see Cher. Everyone just like got out their cameras and just, it's like the Queen's arrived. And walking in with Pier Paolo, Dame Joan Collins, who I think epitomizes the word camp. This was her Met Ball. I think she was had one of that hands down. This hair, I decided for this Valentino look, first of all, it was gonna be short hair, no. Then it was gonna be an afro hair, no. And then we decided to have 40 inches of hair. We wanted long hair. We thought 40 inches would be perfect. Thank you all for joining me on my Met Ball looks. I want to thank you, Anna, for having me for so many years, from when I first went to where we are now. Wow, wow, wow. Congratulations, bravo, because it's really an event.